Hi, I'm Bill the Geek, broadcasting not live from Chapala, Mexico. This video is all about how you can live in Mexico and make money. I've been living in Mexico for 16 years, and I do business in California, New York, New Jersey, Ohio, Florida, Texas, New Mexico, Nebraska, North Carolina, Arizona, Missouri, Utah, Colorado, Illinois, Nevada, Michigan, Pennsylvania, New Jersey. Those are a few states that I do business in. But why only do business in the United States when you can do business in England, France, Italy, Japan, Australia, Canada, Greece, and Germany? In making these videos, my goal is to show you places where you can live in Mexico very affordably, but also I want to show you how you can make money online. So it's like you can live in Guadalajara, the cost of living is going to be higher, but it's going to be much lower than the United States. But if you can find a place like Chapala, Ajijic, Malaki, and you can pay $300 a month in rent, and the food is really cheap, and you have your internet all hooked up and you're making money online, you can live right next to the ocean and have a great life. We do a lot of Mexico travel videos. We have a video on Puerto Vallarta, Guadalajara, Zapopan, Ajijic, Chapala, Lake Chapala. Next week, we're going to Malaki. And while we're in Malaki, we're going to another couple of small towns. I like living in Mexico because it's cheap and it's warm all year. And I like living in Chapala because there's no humidity and we haven't seen a cloud here in about 4 months. This is the Bill the Geek channel, and most of our videos are on Mexico travel and how to do computer art. I specialize in Adobe products. What we really want to do is to encourage people to live good and to live free. A lot of people move to Ajijic and Chapala or other places in Mexico to retire. But I've been here 16 years. Why wait until you're 65 to live a good life? I encourage you younger people, 25 years or older, to move down here and start enjoying life and building your business so you can enjoy those 40 to 50 years. And then when you're 65, just keep on going. Keep on creating. I know stuff. I'm a computer geek. I specialize in Adobe products, all things Adobe. Photoshop, Illustrator, Dreamweaver, Adobe Premiere, and I do web design. I've been doing web design for about 40 years. I have one of the oldest websites on the internet, sillybilly.com. I was investigated by the FBI because they didn't know what internet websites were for. Disney and sillybilly.com were both investigated by the FBI. I teach HTML, CSS, WordPress, and other forms of computer graphic code. I also teach video editing with Camtasia Studio or Adobe Premiere. More important than anything is I teach search engine optimization. Some people call it SEO. That's how do you get your web pages to show up on page one of Google, or how to get your YouTube videos to show up on page one in YouTube. So this video is all about, can you make money living in Mexico as an American? Well, yes, you can. Sure, I have American friends who own shops, they own restaurants, they own hotels, but my philosophy is, if I've got to touch something or go somewhere and make money, I don't want to do it. All of the countries that I do business in, all of the states that I do business in the United States, I do it right from my studio here in Mexico, and that's what I've been doing for the last 16 years. So I just want to share with you in this video how I got started and how my online businesses evolved over the last 16 years. My life in Mexico started actually in San Francisco. I was teaching computer graphics courses in downtown San Francisco, and the vice president of Citigroup Events contacted me and wanted to teach animation to her senior graphic designers in New York City. And I asked her, how are we going to do that? And she said, web conferencing. So for a month, I would teach their senior designers this program called Flash, which kind of is non-existent now. But I would teach them. I had three of their designers, and we would sign on. For me, at 7 o'clock in the morning. For them, it would be 10 o'clock in the morning. And we would have sessions for 2 hours a day for about a month. And they were paying me like $125 an hour. At that point, I figured out, you know, I can live anywhere in the world and do this. So I packed my bags, and when I came to Mexico, I came with a hard drive and a trash bag filled with clothes. I didn't have hardly any money. I had enough money to pay first month's rent, last month's rent. I had my internet service all set up in Mexico, ready to go. So the day after my plane landed, I could start teaching classes. Now let me say, before I came to Mexico, I took about 3 months to see if I could get enough classes to pay rent and buy food. And my fee back then, that's 16 years ago, was $35 an hour. So if I could teach 4 classes a day, that was like $140, which is a lot of money in Mexico. That's a lot of money in the United States. So I was teaching about 20 hours worth of classes, and the money was good and it was coming in, and I was picking up clients all over the United States, and that's when I made my move to Mexico. Things have changed in the last 16 years. So courses like Photoshop, web design, even search engine optimization, who's not doing that online? Who's not teaching that online? But for people that know specific things, if you're like some weird kind of attorney, some weird form of accounting, if I were a psychologist, I would sure be doing counseling sessions online. If you have a specialty, something unique that you can do online and charge people like $50, $100 an hour in the United States, then do it in Mexico. You can teach painting, you can teach knitting, you can do this online in one-on-one sessions. People pay me via PayPal, and then I transfer the money into my bank account into the United States. You can do it too. You'll be totally free. So yeah, I did one-on-one classes. I still do one-on-one classes. I have some clients that have been with me for 10 to 8 years, and we do weekly sessions. My fees have gone up to $45 an hour. But there came a point where I didn't want to talk to people anymore. So a friend of mine was putting books on Amazon, and he was making a lot of money, so I tried that out. Now I have 300 books on Amazon. I make money on Amazon every day. I have, you can look up Bill the Geek on Amazon. I think Bill the Geek has 1 or 2 books on Amazon. But I have 2 other pen names. One pen name does nonfiction books like how to do stuff. How to make wine, how to make beer, how to grow orchids, how to grow roses. I have 150 books up on that pen name. I have another pen name that is all romance. I do regular romance. I do different types of romance. I have some erotica. I have some lesbian romance. And these books sell every day. I get a check from Amazon every month. And you can write books for Amazon. And some people think a book has to be like 400, 600 pages long. No. If you go to Amazon, you'll see that many books are only 50 pages long. So Amazon, I've been with them for about 4 or 5 years. It's a steady income, and I make money when I'm at the grocery store on Amazon. Please leave a comment. What didn't I say? What should I have said? What questions do you have? Please leave a comment, and I will get back to you within 24 to 48 hours. Please do. So please subscribe. We're going to have a bunch of more Mexico travel videos. We're going to show you how to get on page one of Google. We're going to have some web design videos. We're going to have some YouTube videos, some video editing videos. So you don't want to miss a thing. Watch these videos, see where you can live in Mexico affordably, see what I've learned over the last 16 years, and learn how you can make money online in Mexico, living cheap, living good. Subscribe. My latest source of income is YouTube. I've had videos on YouTube for 15 years. Now, I also have had subscription services. That's another way you can make money online. I would have like 30 how-to Adobe Photoshop videos, and if you wanted to see them, you had to pay me $25 a year, okay? Same with Adobe Illustrator, same with using WordPress. These were all subscription services, and I still make money from subscription services. So I had hundreds of videos up on these various web design, computer graphics applications, and I didn't know you could make money on YouTube, but then I figured out that you can. So now I make videos, Mexico travel, how to do this, computer graphics, how to be on page one of Google, and now I get a check every month from YouTube. So I have three or four sources of income, and I never leave my apartment, and the money is good. Now, let me say this. I do this because Mexico is good living, and it's cheap. I was living in Cincinnati, I left Cincinnati in the year 2000. When I left Cincinnati, I needed to make $7,000 a month. And that was without any food or gasoline. $7,000 a month. I mean, I lived in one of the nicest neighbors in Cincinnati. I had two cars. I had the whole thing going. But $7,000 a month, that's crazy. I can live down here and making... if I make $1,000, $1,200 a month, that covers everything and food and gasoline. I'm not saying that's what I make, but that's all I need to make. When you're earning money in Mexico, the people down here are wonderful and friendly. The weather is great and it's really cheap. And you don't have to go to some office somewhere and deal with people that you don't like. You're doing your own thing. You don't have to make that $7,000 a month to live a miserable life. You can come down here, make $1,000. If you can make $2,000, and you're on Happy Street all of the time. Your life will just totally change. Well, that's it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. This is Bill the Geek broadcasting not live from Chapala, Mexico. Hit the subscribe button and I'll see you in the next go-round.